We will see now. So all of you can just write down module 3, strip lines and basic parameters of antenna. So we'll see now strip lines. So you can just write down strip lines, STRIP, strip lines, STRIP, strip lines. So we are going to see here strip lines, and we'll be studying microstrip lines, parallel strip lines, coplanar strip lines, and shielded strip lines. If you see the syllabus, these are the four things what you have to study in module 3. So all of you write down module 3, strip lines and antenna basics. So you'll be studying strip lines half of the module and antenna basics in the next half of the module. So write down module 3. So you should know that now we are in module 3, and we are going to study the strip lines. There are four basic strip lines. You are able to see this, no, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have four basic strip lines, that is micro strip lines, parallel strip lines, coplanar strip lines, and shielded strip line. The beauty of this module is that we have few equations to memorize and few things to understand. This is what strip lines is like. It's a microwave equipment used for coaxial lines or waveguides or parallel strip line circuits, which is after some time the we have monolithic microwave integrated circuits. Strip lines are these strip lines are basically used to send the signal from one end to another. So you can use any of this as per your requirement. So they have different shapes and different orientations in such to classify them. So micro strip lines and coplanar strip lines are used to provide one of the free and accessible surface on which the solid state devices can be placed, and this surface is used to transmit the signal. So there are four basic type of strip lines possible. That is, you have, as I have been discussing with you have micro strip lines, parallel strip lines, coplanar, and shielded strip lines. So these are the four basic strip lines which you are going to study here in this module, and which is used for the transmission of signal from one side to another. And these signals can be means you can understand that what is the losses in that, what are the attenuation losses which is going to take place, or what are the process it is going to take place, how this micro strip lines means how they are, what is parallel strip line, and what do you mean by coplanar and shielded, what are the difference between them. All those things we'll be studying in this module. So you can just write down this introduction, module 3, strip lines, STRIP, strip. So write down, microwave equipments are used, coaxial lines, waveguides, or parallel strip line circuits. So you can note down this introduction, each strip line in detail, and we'll understand what are the differences, what are the advantages, what are the classifications of that, how the equations are used to measure the constants, and all those things we'll see. Okay. So we'll see the figure here. So just it is an example of a strip line. We are not it's actually a micro strip line. So what you can see here is you have the dielectric substrate, you have a ground plane. So you can see here this portion is the dielectric substrate, and this side down you can see the ground plane here. So you can see a ground plane here. This side also it is going ground plane, and you have the dielectric space here. Then you can see as well as this portion, that is this is called as a strip conductor. This section which I have shown in color, you can see that it is the strip conductor. And here what you can find here is a width W. So the width of the conductor is W. The thickness of this conductor is T. So this thickness is T. and the dielectric substrate is of thickness h, and you have a ground plane as well. So dielectric substrate is epsilon r. So you have a strip conductor which is passing on a dielectric substrate. So this is what you can see. So this is a microstrip line. So we'll see once again. I'll just explain you. You have a ground plane, and then on top of the ground plane, you have a dielectric substrate of epsilon r, which is of height h. And this is the strip conductor which is going on top of the dielectric substrate with a thickness t and with a width of w. So this through which signals can be transmitted further. So this is what it is called as a microstrip line. You can draw this figure and just mark all these things. And here you have two portions of fields. That is, one is electric field, another is magnetic field. You can see that all the electric fields are moving in this way, and you can see all this. And the magnetic field, you can see that the magnetic field is in this way. So you have the electric fields and magnetic fields for this conductor, this strip conductor. This is the conductor of thickness t and width w. So that is what you have been here. We'll be studying much in detail. This is just an introduction about it. We need to understand so many things here. You can see that the fields are moving both in dielectric space as well as in the free air. So we'll be studying. So it is called as quasi TEM mode of operation and all. So we'll see that further in detail. Just you can draw this figure. This is just for a introduction section. Then with microstrip lines. So just to start with microstrip lines, consist of, I have already explained you, it has a ground plane and a thin strip conductor on low loss dielectric substrate above the ground plane. So you have the same thing. You can, you have to just draw this figure again once more, this one, where you can see that the width of the strip is W. You can see that this is the width of the strip. This is the strip, this is the microstrip, and its width is W, and its thickness is T, and you have a dielectric, low dielectric substrate being placed at here, that is H. You have a ground plane, and you have a dielectric substrate of epsilon R, and you have both electric and magnetic fields surrounding to that. So you can just note down this few explanations on that. Write down the first topic, microstrip lines. So you can also give a name for this microstrip as open strip line as well. So another name for a microstrip line, it is also called as open strip line. And these are the things with W, thickness T. It has both electric and magnetic fields moving in both dielectric space as well as in the free air space. So we'll be calling it as quasi TEM and all. So those things we'll be studying it further. So this this you can note down with this figure. Field lines are partly remain in air and partly in the dielectric substrate. So you can just write it till here. Then we will continue from here onwards in the next class. You have a placement training program. So we will wind up for today, and you can join for the next class. So you can just note down till here, lower dielectric substrate. So the modes of microstrip lines are quasi, as I have been explaining you, it is quasi transverse electric and magnetic field. So your quasi TEM it is. So you can just note these things, and we will stop it here. Okay. So the radiation loss in microstrip line is a problem at discontinuities and corners and so on. So the radiation loss is proportional to square of the frequency. By using thin and high dielectric material, the radiation losses can be reduced. So we will discuss this again in the next class from microstrip line onwards. You can just note down these things. And we have studied that the strip lines are moving on top of the dielectric substrate, or it will be within the dielectric substrate used for the transmission of signals. And here we have four types of strip lines: microstrip lines, parallel, coplanar, and shielded. So this is what we have seen. If you see the microstrip line, you have a dielectric substrate. On top of that, you have the strip conductor, and the height of the dielectric substrate will be H, and the width of the strip conductor will be W, and T will be the thickness, and it will be supported by a ground plane. So this is what the electric and magnetic fields of which is going to be there. And you understood that the electric and magnetic fields will be passing through the dielectric substrate as well as through the air. So since the electric and magnetic fields which passes through both dielectric substrate as well as in the air, so we call those type of things as quasi TEM. That's what we have seen in the yesterday's class, that is called as quasi transverse electric and magnetic field, because it passes through both dielectric substrate and air space. So that is one thing. And the radiation losses in microstrip line is a problem because of the continuities at the corner. So you can see that discontinuities. So here you can see here that there are some corner space and all those things. So here you can see some corner space is there, and this corner space, whatever it is available, this side and this side, can lead to some discontinuities in the transmission of the signal. So those things also plays a major role. So discontinuities at the corners and so on is one of the problem. And the radiation loss is proportional to the square of the frequency. That is what you can understand. The losses, what it takes place, will be square of the frequency. And by using thin and high dielectric material, the radiation losses can be reduced. We cannot eliminate those losses, but we can reduce those losses. So we will continue with the characteristic impedance of microstrip lines. So here, so we will start from here today. So as you know that microstrip lines are basically used for the transmission of the signal, and you have the characteristic impedance means Z naught. Z naught is the characteristic impedance, and Z naught for the microstrip line, how to calculate the characteristic impedance for the microstrip line. So this is what we have to understand. We have few equations to do that, and so a lot of research has been carried out in this field in order to calculate the characteristic impedance. But it was, since it is a flat and long plane, it was slightly difficult for them to understand the real equation for what the characteristic impedance will be very much close to. So what they have done is, like the plane flat surface, they have made it into a circular form where you have quite a lot of equations to, and it becomes easy for them to find out the characteristic impedance. So once you can just listen to that, then we'll write down these things. So Z naught is what we are going to find out for the characteristic impedance of a microstrip line. And Z naught of a microstrip line is a function of strip line width W. You know that it is of width W and thickness T. So the strip has a width W and thickness T. So you can see here, this is the width W and this is the thickness T. So the distance between the line and the ground plane, these all things we already discussed. The distance between the ground plane and the conductor is almost dielectric constant, that is epsilon r. So that dielectric space is having a height of h, and ground plane with a height of h, and epsilon re of the dielectric substrate is considered here. This is the dielectric constant, and we have to find out Z naught. To find out Z naught, we have to compare and find out the impedance. So what we can observe here is when they found using a flat rectangular space, so they found that the equations are not coming close to what it is required. So after doing a lot of research, they found that this has to be modified. This rectangular space has to be modified into a circular one, and which has a diameter d, and it's of the shape of a wire. So that is what I have also explained here. The wire over ground line of diameter d is taken. So this thing, whatever you have here, it is modified into this form for the simplification of this process and to get the equation in a specific way. So what you can understand here is the wire over ground line of diameter d with its axis at a height h. So other things will remain here same. The height is h, and the dielectric constant is there, epsilon r, and the ground plane is there. Only the width w and t, thickness t, has been converted into a circular wire of diameter d, and which is filled. So all this space between the ground plane and the dielectric is filled with means. Ground plane and the sheet is filled with the dielectric space. So it is of height h, and it remains the same. They are not changing anything with respect to that. Only what they have converted here is the rectangular plane has been converted into circular form for the simplification of the equation. So when they did that, they found that the diameter is d, and you can write the characteristic equation for the wire over ground using this equation. Z naught is equal to 60 by root of epsilon r ln 4 pi 4 h by d. So this equation will come to that. Just you can note down these things. So we are going to directly write the equation for the characteristic impedance Z naught by using the diameter of the wire. See, have you completed the figure?
No, sir.
Okay. So completed. Then we will move on to the equations.
Completed, sir.
Okay, so we will continue further. So these are the conversions which is going to take place, and as I have discussed with you, you can just see that they by using the process of converting it in the form of a circular wire, we have a diameter of d, and the height, all those things remains h for the dielectric substrate, and you have followed by a ground plane. So the space between the wire and the ground plane is filled by dielectric material, as I have already discussed with you. When we use the concept of this, the characteristic impedance, it is easy to write for a wire over ground, and the characteristic impedance is written as Z naught is equal to 60 divided by root of epsilon r ln 4h divided by d, where the condition here is h should be always greater than d. And now we are going to see that the effective dielectric constant epsilon re, and by this all things you have to remember, because we are not deriving anything, or we are directly writing the equations here. We are not deriving these things, and it is not required for you in your syllabus as well. It's a long, very long derivations. So Z naught is equal to 60 by root of epsilon r ln 4H by D is the characteristic impedance of wire over ground, and the effective dielectric constant can be written as epsilon RE. It is 0.475 epsilon R plus 0.67. So this has been, they have derived at these equations after a lot of trial and error method, and they found that this equation suits better for dielectric constant, effective dielectric constant, as well as for the characteristic impedance Z naught. So we'll be using these equations by substituting, and we'll be simplifying it further. And we have one or two cases as well, when the thickness is more or width is more, all those things we'll be seeing it on further. So you can just note down these two equations as well. Then we'll move on to the substitution and simplification of this process further. So just note down these things, note down the equation for characteristic impedance of wire over ground and the effective dielectric constant. See, once you complete it, you just let me know that we'll proceed further with the substitution and simplification of these equations. So here you can see that you will be coming across a lot many equations to just remember. So how best you can remember this equation. So once you understand this and memorize these things, then this module, you will not lose even a single mark. Okay, that is very much important for you. So whether it is university exam or internals, whatever it is, this module, you can get full marks if you just remember these equations properly. There will be no twisted questions as such. Almost I can say around 25 equations may be there for you to memorize in this entire module. So you should not just make any mistake in that. So we will be directly writing the equations like we have written for the characteristic impedance Z naught and for epsilon RE effective dielectric constant. So if you are asked to find out the characteristic impedance, so you can use these equations in order to find. We'll be just modifying these equations further. So you have completed it. Have you completed till here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So continuation of this, just remember these two equations for this at this point of time. So we'll use these two equations and you will substitute and simplify it further. So here you can just note down these things. Epsilon R is called as the relative dielectric constant, and epsilon RE is called as the effective relative dielectric constant for the microstrip line. So as I have told you, we'll be still using a few more equations. So like the diameter D of the wire over ground is given as D is equal to 0.67 W into 0.8 plus T by W. So this is what the equation for diameter D is, which is there for the wire over ground. And D is given as 0.67 W, 0.8 plus T by W. You can see in the previous equation, you can see that you have the parameter D, you have the parameter epsilon R. So we will be substituting whatever we are having here in this equation further on. So that's the reason we need these terms to simplify the equation further. So D is given as 0.67 W and point into 0.8 plus T by W. So W, you know that width of the microstrip line. So how the, as I have told you before, if you see the figure, you have here width and you have here T, but it has been converted into a wire of diameter D. So we have to interrelate this D with respect to W and T, and how they have interrelated this D with respect to W and T is given here, that is 0.67 W into 0.8 plus T by W. So W is width of the microstrip line and T is the thickness of the microstrip line. So this is what you can just note down these things. And further, the relaxation holds good when, and we can say that if you are taking the ratio of H and W, H is the height of the dielectric constant and W is the width of the microstrip line. If you're taking the ratio varying from 0.1 to 0.8, then you can say that all this, whatever equations you are studying or you are doing, it holds good. Means it will be a good, it will be very close to what calculations you are doing. If it crosses more than this, you can say that it might not be the reality what it is there actually. So to find out the things, we can find H by W as well. It should be between 0.1 and 0.8. Then these equations will hold good. So why I am saying this to you is, here it is very clearly mentioned here that H should be greater than D to make this equation hold good. So that's the reason we are just calculating H and W, and it should be between 1.1 and 0.8 for this equation to be a perfect calculation for D, or it can be epsilon R, or it can be Z naught, anything. So you can just note down these things. Further on, we'll be using the process of substitution to find out the characteristic impedance. We'll, whatever we got D and epsilon, we'll be substituting it. So these things you can just note down, and then we'll go for the process of substitution and simplification for the characteristic impedance. So write down these things. So here you can understand that you need to remember Z naught, you need to remember epsilon R equation, you need to remember equation for diameter D. Then you can complete this process. Further on, you can just substitute and simplify. No need to remember any equations further on. But to some equations, the last final equation also, you need to remember if any problem comes for you to solve. So you will be directly using those equations. So it's all total, you have to, whatever equations come for you, I can say around 25 equations will come in this half of the module. So those things, it is better to keep it note on no keep a note on all this in a sheet of paper separately with all these equations. Try to read 2-3 times. It becomes familiar for you, these equations. See here, it is very easy to understand. D is 0.67, so 6, 7, 8 it is there. So 0.67 W, 0.8 plus T by W, so 6, 7, 8. So you can remember it is 6, 7, 8. So like that, you can just memorize these things. So here also it is like that only. If you see here, here you have again 6, 7, and in here it is 0.475. So it is also easy to understand. Just 2 times of practice will make it clear for you. So just write down these things. Epsilon r is related dielectric constant. Epsilon r e is effective related dielectric constant. W is thick width and T is thickness. So we will, I think you might have completed by this time. Have you completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you just take this equation. You can put this as equation number one. The first equation for Z naught is equal to 60 divided by root of epsilon r ln 4h by d. You can put it as one. And if you're putting it 2 and 3 for the other two equations, you can say that substituting. So the characteristic impedance Z naught of narrow microstrip line is what we have done is we have just substituted those things. You can see that the equation for D is substituted here. So the D, you can see that D is substituted here, and you have this as well getting substituted. So you can substitute in the equation, and then we will go with the process of simplification. So first you can substitute epsilon r and d in the equation number one, and you can simplify it. So when you substitute, you'll get 60 divided by root of 0.475 epsilon r plus 0.67 ln 4h by 0.67 w into 0.8 plus t by w, and you are just simplifying it in this form. You are taking root of 0.475 outside, then you will be getting epsilon r plus 0.67 divided by 0.475 ln 4 divided by 0.67 h. We are taking it outside. So leftover terms will be this one. So finally, when you simplify using calculator, you will get 87. So 87 divided by root of epsilon r plus 1.41 ln. When you do the calculation using calculator, you'll get 5.98 h divided by 0.8 w plus t. So this equation holds good when h is less than 0.8 W. This is being taken from here. H by W is 0.8. So this equation holds good when H is less than 0.8 W. So we get the equation for this equation. You need to remember this equation will be used for problems to solve to find out the characteristic impedance of a narrow microstrip line. So underline this thing in your book. Narrow microstrip line. Why we are calling it as narrow microstrip line? Because we are using the condition h less than 0.8 W. So underline this carefully, because in problems we have to use two equations are there here for the characteristic impedance Z naught. So this is one of the equation for Z naught where we are using it for narrow microstrip line. So underline that, you need to understand that it is for narrow microstrip line. That's the reason I am saying it. Underline this thing, and this equation you can put it in square bracket. And this condition is also very important. So here epsilon r is relative dielectric constant, h is height from the microstrip line to the ground, w is width and t is thickness. So all these things are quite familiar to you. So you can just complete it, and then we will proceed further. So this is the equation for narrow microstrip line. So Z naught is equal to 87 divided by, you need to remember this equation, 87 divided by root of epsilon r plus 1.41 ln 5.98 h divided by 0.8 w plus t. So it will be easy for you. You just keep a paper in front of you, and in the class itself you can just keep noting down the equations simultaneously in a different sheet, and you can just go through those equations. So no need to, or when you are studying you can do that, but you must do that, otherwise you will find it difficult to remember these equations when more number of equations get added to it. So epsilon r h w and t is familiar to you, relative dielectric constant, height, width and thickness. So w and t is width and thickness of the microstrip line. So all of you have completed the characteristic impedance Z naught equation. This is for narrow microstrip line. Have you completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So write down that parameters as well, epsilon r h w and t. So here we can also find out the velocity of propagation, that is v. It is c by root of epsilon r. C is 3 into 10 to the power of 8. So 3 into 10 to the power of 8 divided by root of epsilon r meter per second. As well as the characteristic impedance of a wide microstrip line, I have been mentioning you, we are studying previously, it is narrow microstrip line. So this one is for wide microstrip line. So underline these things, wide microstrip line. So we are going to find out the characteristic impedance of a wide microstrip line. So it is given as Z naught is equal to H by W root of mu by epsilon. And we know that all these values, when you substitute, you will get 377 divided by root of epsilon r H by W. So H and W is height of the dielectric, and W is the width of the strip line. So we have to understand that W should be greater than H in order to use this equation. So when you get a problem, first thing is that you have to find out whether H is less than 0.8 W or whether W is greater than H. So based on that, you are going to decide whether it is a narrow strip line or a wide strip line. So if it is a wide strip line, you have to go with this equation, 377 by root of epsilon r h by w. So you can note down these two equations. So it's very important for you to understand both the equations. So here, usually the material used for microstrip is copper. So this can be asked for a Viva question as well. You will be having strip conductors in the lab as well. So you will be material used for microstrip is copper, and the value of Z naught will vary between 50 and 150 ohm. Usual practice, it will be Z naught will be between 50 ohm to 150 ohm. So you can just note down this thing. So you have seen two equations here. One equation for Z naught when it is in the narrow micro strip line, and we have also seen characteristic impedance Z naught when it is wide micro strip line. So you need to classify these things. And first, if you get some problems, you need to find out whether it is a narrow micro strip line or a wide micro strip line, and then use the equations to find out the characteristic impedance. So some students will not understand that. They use sometimes if you use for a wide micro strip line equation for of a narrow, then this it will go wrong. Okay, so first you have to find out the condition whether W is greater than H. If it is greater than H, then it will be a wide micro strip line and you have to go ahead with this equation. So we'll be doing some different problems which is based on narrow micro strip line as well as for wide micro strip line. So we'll use those equations in the appropriate places and we'll be finding out those things. So you complete it, then we'll move on to the problems.
Wait, sir.
Yeah, I will be waiting. So those who have completed, you can just note down this problem. A certain microstrip line has the following parameters. Epsilon r is 5.23 and h is 7 mils, t is 2.8 mils, w is 10 mils. Calculate the characteristic impedance Z naught. So you can find out whether you have to use a equation for a wide microstrip line or a narrow microstrip line to find out the characteristic impedance Z naught. So use the equation for which one you are going to use, whether you are going to use narrow or wide microstrip line. See which equation you are going to use for characteristic impedance Z naught. See one of you can say.
Wide microstrip, sir.
How come you calculate this one first? Ratio you calculate. Whether you see H and W, whether it is H by W less than 0.8. What is 7 and 10? So 7 divided by 10, 0.7. So which one you have to use? Narrow. See, H is 0.7 and W is 10. So 7 divided by 10, you will get 0.7. So it is less than 0.8. So you need to go with narrow. First, you need to check whether it is narrow. If it is not satisfying this condition, then it will be wide. So here you are getting the ratio 0.7, which is within 0.8. So you can use narrow microstrip line equation. So you'll get 87 divided by root of epsilon r plus 1.41 ln 5.98 h divided by 0.8 w plus t. Substitute the values of h, w, t and epsilon r. So you can substitute as 7, 2.8, 10 and 5.23. So if anyone of you got the answer, you just let me know. Anyone of you got the answer? Solve it and just let me know the answer. Use the calculator properly. It is ln natural logarithm.
Sir, 46.52.
Yeah, I think it's correct. You'll get once the decimal places. So 87 divided by root of 5.23 plus 1.41 ln 5.98 into 7 divided by 0.8 into 10 plus 2.8.
The t value, it is 2.5 or 2.8, sir?
It is, t is 2.8, no, here.
Okay, sir.
2.8. You correct it in the question. It is 2.8. Okay, that's why a small change was there in your answer. So you can just correct it. So 0.87 divided by root of this ln 5.98 into 7, 0.8 into 10 plus 2.8. So do the, if you have completed, you can just write down the next problem or we'll stop it here. All of you can do this and try with this. You will get 45.78, which is the answer for Z naught, the characteristic impedance. So second problem, we will do it in the next class. So we'll stop it for today. If you have any doubts or anything to be discussed, you can just let me know that. It's all clear for everyone? See, it's clear for everyone?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, thank you. So we'll stop it for today and we'll continue in the next class with the second problem onwards. So that's all. Thank you for everyone.